All right, so let's go ahead and get started. One of the most important things, Kayla, when our dealers are showing the machine, and I'm not going to teach you how to sell a machine, but you need to know how the machine works. And so I'm videoing myself because I'm going to send this out to all our dealers on what has to get accomplished in the presentation. Okay, so we know about the Rainmate, right?
Yes.
All right, so the most important thing is that we have to build the need. Did Kevin build the need with you yesterday?
Yes. Yeah.
How did he build the need? Tell me about it.
He talked about the filtration systems that are in our houses and how they may not be like super effective. And then talked about went into like cold and flu season, how that's coming up, if there are kids in the home or pets in the home.
Okay.
That.
Okay, so I'm going to teach you how to build a need. Okay, how to build a need. So you have two ways. One, we're going to find out as you start to call you the leads. One is having what we call, they already have a need, but the key of this business is to create more customers or writers, because writers is what really gets us going. Some of those writers, we have to educate that they have a need. So I always use what is called my umbrella story. Okay. So I have the greatest umbrella in the world. Just like the rainbow is the greatest air purifier in the world. Okay? So I have this great umbrella. It's sunny out. This umbrella is $200. Are you buying it today? Greatest umbrella in the world.
Even though it would be great, but we don't need it.
So you're not going to make a decision unless you need something.
It's true.
Okay. So now let me develop a need. And this is what I do. Okay. How do I develop a need? I do it through a story, but so I'm going to develop a need. So how old are you?
24.
24. Next year you're getting married.
Okay.
Yes. Boyfriend's kind of well off. This is where you and your bridesmaids are getting ready. Over across the street over there, about 100, 200 yards away, is the church. And you're supposed to leave, and it starts to rain. And I'm selling umbrellas. For 200, right?
For whatever, I think on the wedding day, anyone would spend whatever to make sure that
so
they
got
to the
1,000?
Yeah.
2,000.
If it was in the budget.
Okay, I stop there.
Really needed one.
I stop there. I say 2,000.
Okay.
I say you're wearing a Giorgio Armani wedding dress, $25,000, and I'm selling a $5,000 umbrella.
That $5,000 umbrella doesn't even put a dent in how much.
Now the church bells are ringing and people don't think you're coming, so they're getting ready to leave. How much could I say? See, as I put in needs, I get people not only to want the product, because everybody wants the rainbow, but for people to make a decision, they have to need it. And our programs allow them to afford it. Okay, so how do I build a need? When I walk into the home, my front talk is very simple. I don't want to make this any big mystery. I know you guys probably have some form of great cleaning system to take care of the source of what I'm about to talk about, or some form of air purification. 95% of the homes use the HVA system as their form of purification with usually a very good air filter. Okay, we're going to talk about that here in just a second. All right. So I hope those things last you the rest of your life, but if they ever, go ahead.
I have a question. So ideally, if someone had a rainbow system in their house and they were using it, would that potentially cut down on like the amount that would theoretically would cut down on the amount of like dirt and buildup
correct.
In the HVAC correct. System filter?
Correct. Absolutely correct. So let me go back through this because you have to, I want you to, you're going to have questions afterwards. So let's do the questions afterwards because I think I'll answer all your questions.
Okay.
So let's go back to, I don't want to create a big mystery. I know you probably have some form of good cleaning system, such as a vacuum cleaner, because there's only two things used to clean the air of your home. The vacuum cleaner takes care of the source. You use it, most people, 95% of the people, use their HVAC system with a high quality HEPA filter in their furnace, okay? And they use that, okay? And I hope those things last you the rest of your life. If they ever break down or they're not working up to as high as efficiency, you might give me a call a couple years down the road, okay? Now, one of the most important things is understanding indoor out air pollution. And unfortunately, our customers are very educated on indoor air pollution, okay? And the reason they're very educated, and I say unfortunately, is because we just went through a pandemic a couple years ago. And everybody that went inside a home, went inside a house, went inside an office building, went inside a doctor's office, went inside the bank, in the mall, they had to wear what?
A
mask. Okay? But you could go outside to 50,000 screaming people at a stadium and you didn't have to wear what? A mask. Because Mother Nature cleaned the outside of the air through some form of moisture, whether it be rain, snow, sleet, or fog. But inside here is the problem. Because back in the late 70s, early 80s, we introduced building codes. And those building codes really got the country less needing oil and things like that. And let me explain why. Because we weren't asked to, we were told to, if we're building a new home, a building or anything, we had to put 4-inch insulation in the walls. We had to put 6-inch insulation in the ceilings. We had to have double pane windows, magnet sealed doors. So we have sealed up our home and we've made it an incubator for viruses, allergies, and bacterial infections because they have no place to go once they come in. And that's why you see these expensive filters for the HVA system, but they're called dry filtration. And this is so important you understand the difference between dry filtration and wet filtration. And I'm going to show you here in just a second, okay? So it really is that important. So what I'm about to bring out to you is you've seen the Rainmate, and the Rainmate is a toy. I didn't say it's a toy. It's a toy compared to the Rainbow. The Rainmate is not a certified air purifier because to be a certified air purifier, it has to go through rigorous by AHAM. So the machine I'm about to show you here today has, first of all, I'll tell you the quality of the machine, has a 10-year warranty, 4 years on all the other things, okay? It's ran by an onboard computer, okay? It's not, doesn't have a typical armature motor. It has a series, works through a series of magnets, which is also, what we do here is we have a patented separator, which separates us, separates the water from the air and us from our competition, okay? So I put the water in here already. I get and I'm just share with you tap water. So we're going to just highlight the machine a little bit. So this machine is designed to last warranty up to 10 years. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is called our light show. And I'm going to take the front of this off. And what's so important here is I'm just going to talk a little bit because see, let me go back through this. 40 years ago, you walked into the Rite Aid, CVS, Walgreens, and you had to ask the pharmacist, where's the allergy medicines?
Yep.
Okay? Because only 4% to 10% of the American public had severe allergies. Today, because of what I talked about, sealing up our home, way more people have severe allergies. Matter of fact, 40% of the American people, or 4 out of every 10 people, say they have some form of allergy. And the reason why is because our immune system has been compromised because we go into our homes. So what the Rainbow uses is water as the filter. And I'm just going to turn this on here. So the Rainbow has 4 different speeds, okay? It has a high, medium, and low. And it has a hurricane motor, which means it moves air at 70 miles per hour, which is the first level of a hurricane. So, and that's the quiet mode. And you can run this 24 hours a day, 7 days a week if you'd like to. And it is filtering the dust because it's completely sealed. It's AHAM certified, and it's also a member of the Allergy Friendly, okay? It also has a timer on this side that you can actually plan to go out or leave for the day, and you can have it run every 30, 60, or 90 minutes. So right now, the machine is moving, and just to give you an idea of the airflow in this,
unbelievable, isn't it?
It moves air, and that's why we have to put a backing on it. Now, this is called, so I ran this for how long now? 3-4 minutes? Let it just run for a little bit more. And here's the problem. Do you see the dust flying in the air right now?
No.
Okay. Because you can't see it, but if you
light,
you can see it now. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is a high intensity light, but let's see how our air purifier is working. Is that unbelievable?
Yes, that is crazy. That's very cool.
And that's why, because we had dust all over the place.
Yeah, I always notice around the sun comes in my house.
Do you notice the dust?
Yeah.
Well, you can't see the dust in there now unless you put the high intensity light, because dust is lucent. So what people don't understand about this machine is they're going to run it and it'll get cloudy, but it'll never get like muddy because the light. See, you can't see the dust flying around. It's all over the place. Okay. Mm-hmm. So. That's the first thing that salespeople do, and that is called the light show. Okay. The second thing is, now we have to prove to the people how much will it clean. Normally, on a normal 3,600 square foot home, I would say it would do all the downstairs and part of the upstairs, moving up the steps. Okay. So I'm going to show you how much it does. So I'm going to take a solution here. And I'm going to take eucalyptus because you can smell that the easiest. I'll take lemon. I can see eucalyptus or lemon. And so what I want you to do is, when you pull air in, it pushes air out. So I'm going to show you how much of this will do. And so if you go back there and stand against that back wall.
Back here?
Go a little further. Okay. You're going to be amazed. And you tell me when you smell this. You smell it right now. So as far as you are, it's going that far that way, because you're pulling air through here. So right now it is doing this whole room and outside our office. And remember, it can do 4 different things. It controls odors. It also, this is the eucalyptus I just put in there that you can smell. It, so it medicates. And then it also has, it can use the fresh air triethylene glycol with ethyl alcohol, right, which prevents cross-contamination. Mm-hmm. And we can also use it to aromatize, putting 13 or 14 different scents in it, okay? So that is called our air wash.
Oh.
Light show air wash. That's the first thing. So now that we have the product that everybody wants. So in all sales, there's a feature, there's a benefit, and there's a comparison. So the most important part, what we do now, is we have to compare machines. There's a lot of good machines out in the market. And I'm not going to knock any machine. The difference between our machine and everybody else's machine is what is called dry filtration. Okay? So what most people do is they'll use what is called mechanical filtration, HEPA filtration, which is high efficiency particle arrest. And how that works is you put this, and keep adding layers of filters until you have it so that the airflow traps 99.9% of the dust it creates. Are you following that? Mm-hmm. So, and HEPA filter does exactly that. It does touch on 99.9%. But so does our machine, and we use water as the filtration.
Which is a lot cheaper.
No, that's not the problem. Here's the problem, okay? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go get a regular office chair. I'll be right back here. Give me go a second. So this is the chair that Kevin traditionally sits on. All right, so let's talk about all the filters out there on the market today.
Okay.
The HVA system, you've got two things that uses to clean the air. But the source, so this dust, it all goes down to the carpet, right?
Yes.
Okay. All machines are set up the same way. They have an intake. They have an outtake. They have a motor. And they have a filter. Intake, outtake, motor, filter. Correct. HVA system. Intake, outtake, motor unit on the ceiling with a filter. So everybody uses what is called dry filtration. Am I correct?
Yes.
Right. And what does your common vacuum cleaner use? Dry filtration, either a paper bag or a HEPA filter or sponge filter. So I'm going to duplicate what they all have. So I'm going to turn this in, God forbid, the common vacuum cleaner. And I'm going to put that hose on right like that. And what am I missing right now? I have water as my filter, right? But I want to turn it into dry filter. So I'm going to use these really thin, like, paper filters. You can see right through them.
Okay.
And so what I'm going to do is turn mine into, oh, I dropped that one. I'm going to use two of them. I got it. And I'm going to create a filter. So now I'm everybody's machine right now. I have a intake, an outtake, motor, filter. And I'm going to explain to you the difference between what is called suction and airflow. Because every machine out there says they never lose what?
Suction.
That's right. If you look at the sharp on the advertising on it, it says never lose suction. Mm-hmm. If you look at the Dyson, never lose suction.
Mm-hmm. I have a Dyson. I know that's not true.
And here you go. That is called suction. But the suction clean, because this is called airflow. Suction, airflow. I have a filter in there, so it's working, right? Until I go to clean. This chair looked really clean, didn't it? Okay. I never lose what? What happened? No airflow. What happened? Huh? That's exactly correct. Because the filters all get clogged. So all machines stop working or working to their highest efficiency as soon as you use them. okay? Because we use water as our filter, and we are a certified, we're the only product of its kind that is a certified air purifier. So let's just throw this, let's put this down. And actually, I'm gonna clean this off of here. And I'm going to clean this chair also. I'll even clean the floor. I'll pick up all the dust, all the dirt, and I can clean, and I can clean, and I can clean, and I can clean, and I can clean. And I still have what?
Airflow.
And I still have airflow. And that's the difference between this machine and everybody else's machine on the market. Let me ask you a question. Why'd you buy your refrigerator? Keep your food what?
Cool.
Okay. And if your refrigerator was beyond repair and it only kept your food half cold.
Uh-huh.
So you turn it on, hour later, it now can only keep your food half cold. Would you keep it or get rid of it?
Get rid of it.
And you go buy a new one. When would you buy a new refrigerator?
Probably today? Pretty soon.
Well, what, you gonna throw it, put everything in the icebox?
Well, if I figured financially I couldn't afford a fridge today, I'd have to probably do that. But I would get one as soon as possible.
Because you're not my customer. Now, if you're my customer, husband, wife, gainfully employed, comfortably retired.
Much different buying one today.
That's right. So when I talk to a person such as yourself, and this is why we don't show you the rainbow.
Mm-hmm.
Because
it's an investment.
You can't buy it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If you can't buy a refrigerator, you probably can't buy the machine. Yeah. Okay? So... But if you were in financial care, you'd go buy a refrigerator when?
As soon as possible.
So you would make a $2,600 decision mm-hmm. based on $80 worth of food.
Yes.
Today.
Yep.
Okay, let me ask you a question. You wouldn't have a car got you halfway to work. Wouldn't have an oven got you half food. Did you buy that cleaning system that you currently have to pick up all the dirt or half the dirt?
All the dirt.
And if it only picks up half the dirt, what's the other half doing to your furniture, your carpeting, because that's the wear and tear, and also to your breathing and your allergies and your asthma.
I know. Like yes, it's been terrible.
So that is called I don't have it up here. So that's called the suction versus airflow with the ping pong ball.
Okay.
First was the light show. Second was suction versus airflow with the ping pong ball. And the third thing that I want to highlight with you today
mm-hmm.
is I'm going to leave this connected.
This is so cool.
And really I'm going cool. to plug in the cleaning system here real quick, the power nozzle. Now what's great about this machine is there's a couple things. I'm going to put these aside here. Is before I go on to this, so I would normally show you all the attachments that also come with it. I'm showing you three of the major things that has to be done in a presentation.
Okay.
Well, four. Number one, with the little machine, okay, the Rainbow Mate, which is the little box where the little machine that you haven't seen yet, we do the mattress. And the mattress is the most important thing you can do because of dust mite, feces, and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
The next thing is this part. And so we're an air purifier that happens to vacuum. Okay, and it only makes sense because if we're going after the source, a traditional vacuum is going to spit everything back out into the air. Because once it gets clogged, which is exactly about 4 minutes, it no longer works because the paper bag, the HEPA filter, all of that is completely sealed.
Mm-hmm.
And they lose all their ability to have airflow. Okay? So this is our visualizer. And when you introduce this, You see, there's only two reasons a person buys a vacuum cleaner. Number one is to keep a clean, healthy, wholesome atmosphere. And the second is protect the material possessions that you have in your home. Because it hasn't been a year's marriage to time. It's been a lifetime that you've accumulated all these beautiful things. And don't you really deserve to protect them? So you turn this on because this is the easiest way to do this. You open this up. And this is our visualizer. Normally there is another tube here, but this is to show you and me and the customer how it works. So you put your pad on the upper half, you close this down, and if I don't move it, you will start to see dirt build up right there. Right here. Now this is always cleaned with the rainbow, so there's nothing. Normally you will have pads about this thick.
Oh, I'm sure.
Okay, but if you rub your hand across that, what do you tell me? What you feel? Like sand?
Yeah.
Okay. So sand has 16 to 18 cutting edges. We use sand to sandblast graffiti off walls. We use sand to cut glass. We use sand to cut diamonds. We use sand. So what happens is because the average customer that has a traditional vacuum cleaner, that has a traditional filter, that's why you have a walk area, because they can't get it back up. The sand goes down to the bottom of the pile, and every time you walk across it, every time you actually clean with it, you're breaking the fibers. That's why couches go from that thick to that thin.
Really?
Okay? Now at this point in time, the salespeople are to pull 9 more dirt pads, lay them in front of them, take the filter off, take this off, put the regular tube on, and say, I feel like a used car salesman, I need you guys to go ahead and clean, and they're to clean for about 5 to 10, 15 minutes, letting the customer clean and turning the water completely black. And that's the highlight of the machine, okay?
Beautiful.